Recidivism is the tendency to relapse into a previous condition or mode of behavior. There are a lot of things that people may be addicted to, such as one thing that people do not discuss is the fact that you can become addicted to being a criminal. It's an addiction that you can relapse to just like anything else. But who do we blame for this addiction? Do we blame the person who committed the crime? Do we blame the people who work for the prison systems and the jails? Or do we blame society? What is it that we can do to help stop this never-ending cycle of recidivism? I have added a video from the Bob Barker Company off of YouTube, just letting you know some of the statistics on recidivism in prison and things like that. Recidivism does not only affect the person in and out of prison. It also affects the people close to those people. Whoever cares about them, their friends, their mothers, their fathers, their sisters, their brothers, their aunts, their uncles, their wives, their girlfriends, and most importantly, their children. These children are growing up without fathers and mothers and are 5 times more likely, as you've seen in the YouTube video, to follow in their footsteps. Who is teaching them right from wrong if you're continuing to do wrong? Having faith is probably the most important step in reducing recidivism to me. I feel like the person needs to have faith in themselves. the prison officials need to have faith and give the prisoners resources to be successful once they're out of prison. And the society needs to also help contribute to the resources that the prisons are allowing these people to have by giving them jobs once they're released. Education is also an important factor in reducing recidivism. 80% of men and women who get an education in prison are less likely to return back to prison. Another good thing that prisons can do is have programs that teach the prisoners trades so that it's easy to find them jobs when they get out of prison, and also just doing something as easy as getting them identification so once they get released they can go out on their job search. Prisons should have programs that teach the felons how to apply for applications, because after being in jail for so long you forget things like that, and a thing society can do is stop being so judgmental. Give these people a chance. It's hard enough being a felon, but coming out and not being able to find a job, not being able to provide for your family, that is hard. And it makes people want to go back to their old life and do things that they probably know they shouldn't do, but sometimes you do what you think you need to do just to survive.
Are you willing to take the risk to be out there in the street life, to be out there in what we call the game? Are you willing to take that risk? If you are, hey, more power to you. That's your decision. Remember, that's your decision. And when they slam that gavel, remember that was your decision. So don't be upset when you don't get the letters. Don't be upset when the money's not on the books like somebody told you, because you're going to run into that. People are going to tell you they're sending money and the money is not sent, because they're still living their life. They got bills to pay. They got things to do. People are not going to pick up the phone for you because their phone bill is high. And that's an expensive call coming from a penitentiary. So these are the things you got to, you know, I let a guy know, hey, this is what you got to look forward to. Now, if you accept that, well, man, hey, yeah, so here's where you sign. Sign on this dotted line. Go out there. Do what you got to do, man. Remember, you got to be able to give as well as you get. So this is what you got to look forward to. Now, do you want to really do this? Do you really want to be in this life? Because ain't no half-stepping. You can't say I'm partly in the street. And not, you got to be all the way in there. And guys who play that part, I'm part in the street. When it goes down, those are the ones, who are in there. They got to take all kinds of medication because they can't cope with it. So you got to be mentally prepared. You got to prepare yourself. And that's what I'm doing. I'm commanding. Are you prepared for this life? Are you prepared for life behind bars? Are you prepared for sleeping in the same cell or in this little 5x7 with another man who you might not like? And if you two get into it, where you gonna run to? You got nowhere to run to. You right here in this cell. Y'all gonna have to handle it out like we say, man, handle it, man, in your cell. We'll take that to the cell. That's the life that they got to live. What you got to look forward to. Now weigh it out. You know, some are listening, some not. It is what it is. I mean, that's basically, you know, when I did what I did, a guy I never forget, when the OGs came and told me, he's like, man, he said, man, you know what this usually ends up in? He said, us going to the penitentiary or the grave, one of the two. He said, now, if you sign on, he said, you take this pledge, you take this oath. Remember, that's what's at the end of this rainbow. It's all good. It's all good right now. But at the end, man, this is what we got to look forward to. If we really are deep in the game. And, man, I said, yeah, I'm in. And that's what it ended up. You know, fortunately, I didn't catch the grave. I caught the lighter side of the punishment. Penitentiary. But there's a lot of guys who didn't make it. A lot of guys I know that, you know, lost their life to this thing. So I would just tell, man, I would just tell any up and coming youngster, man, this is what it is. Do you really want this?
For anyone with a family member struggling with recidivism and re-entering in prison, have faith, encourage them, and give them hope. They can make a change.